Good afternoon, everyone. It's my pleasure to welcome all of you this afternoon, students, faculty, staff, family and friends, alums, and Kathleen McCartney, our president and colleague. For those of you watching from home, we are joining you today from the Sweeney Concert Hall at Sage Hall, and this space allows us to remove our masks safely when speaking during this event. As you'll see, all of my colleagues on stage are wearing theirs when they're not here at the lectern speaking. This event is, for many of us at Smith, the highlight of the year. We are honoring three exceptional teachers: Maren Buck, Associate Professor of Chemistry; Gaby Immerman, Senior Laboratory Instructor in Biological Sciences; and Michelle Joffroy, Associate Professor of Spanish and Portuguese. They join 62 colleagues whose work has been acknowledged with a Sherrerd Award, colleagues drawn from a wide array of disciplines and from all ranks of the Smith College faculty. The Sherrerd Prize for Distinguished Teaching was made possible by a grant to the college by Smith alumna Kathleen Compton Sherrerd, a 1954 graduate, and her husband, John J.F. Sherrerd. The Sherrerd's support of excellent and innovative teaching at Smith is also evident in their gift to endow the Sherrerd Center for Teaching and Learning in 2009. The Sherrerd Center, whose director, Sarah Proust, is here — Sarah's right over here — describes the core principles that the center is dedicated to, and the teachers we are celebrating this afternoon exemplify all three of them. Those core principles are, first, that there are many different ways to teach well, and that Smith embraces that richness and variation. Second, that all teaching is improvable, and we dedicate ourselves to the goal of that improvement. And finally, we improve through self-reflection and collaboration, processes that we pursue together, and importantly, that include our students. When we do it right, this teaching thing invites us into lifelong habits of curiosity and critical engagement. It brings us into communities of questioning, and ideally, it opens us up to the pleasure that is inherent in sustained thought and attention. One of the reasons why so many of us in this room share a commitment to Smith and to the profession of teaching and learning is that we ourselves experienced at some point a transformative relationship with a faculty member in the space of the classroom, the lab, or the studio. Many of us remember that one class where you could feel your brain growing, where you could feel your relationship to the world, your relationship to others, your relationship to yourself changing as your understanding deepened. That growth is scaffolded. And in the best relationships with faculty, it happens at moments of meaningful questioning, when faculty welcome students to the very edge of knowledge about some core question that matters in some profound way. As you are going to hear from their former students, we hold each of the colleagues we are here to celebrate today in such high esteem because they are that teacher. These are faculty members with whom students will remember their brains growing, and they will for decades remember being intellectually stretched and pushed in that transformative way. I'm going to turn things over to Kathleen McCartney, president of the college, an educator, researcher, and scholar whose own work has focused on the creation of learning communities. Please welcome her to the podium.
Thank you, Michael. It's wonderful to be here. Good afternoon, everyone. It is truly a joy to be among colleagues and friends to celebrate these three remarkable teachers. Today's ceremony is particularly meaningful given what we have all been through over the past 19 months. The pandemic has tested us in many ways, but one thing that never wavered was Smith's commitment to exceptional teaching. Ever since the pandemic upended our normal way of doing things, I have witnessed the very best from our faculty. Working collaboratively, scholars across the curriculum developed new and innovative ways to teach and engage our students. I'm incredibly proud of how each and every faculty member stepped up to meet the moment. As we all know, faculty are the heart and soul of this place. The work they do transforms lives. As one student recently said, and I quote, "My professors make my Smith experience incredibly meaningful. They are all intensely dedicated to their work, but also to the success and happiness of their students. I can only aspire to one day embody the humility, intellect, and zeal of my professors." I could say it no better. The three extraordinary teachers, scholars, and mentors we celebrate today, Maren Buck, Gaby Immerman, and Michelle Joffroy, exemplify such dedication, and they have inspired their students in profound ways. They encourage their students to explore new intellectual paths, take risks, and research real-world problems. They embrace new teaching methods, as well as a desire to learn and explore alongside their students. They model the great sense of joy that the discovery of new knowledge can bring, empowering their students to pursue their own passions. I'm proud to honor and celebrate these recipients of the 2001 Sherrerd Prize for Distinguished Teaching. I will have more to say about each of them when I read their citations. Thank you.
Good afternoon. My name is May Pryor, and I'm a part of the class of 2021, and I'm really honored to be here today to commend Professor Maren Buck's exceptional teaching. Now, I want you to imagine a scenario in which you are a professor at Smith College. You're teaching, you're running your own research lab, and you're raising two young kids. And it's a bright Saturday morning in March, and you get a frantic call from one of your students. And through the many tears, you somehow make out that this student has flooded your lab. Actually, all four floors at Ford Hall. And while running her first reaction overnight. So you are Professor Buck, and I am that student. Now, I'm not sure if she will ever recover from that incident, even though at the time she showed no such sense of horror at all. But standing here today, I can say with confidence that that was the day that I knew I had a lifelong mentor. Through my 4 years at Smith, Maren has not only taught me how to be a scientist, but she has taught me how to accept, how to move on, and how to learn from failure. If I had to describe Maren in one word, it would be nurturing. She's not only dedicated to giving her students an amazing education, but she's equally dedicated to the growth and well-being of each and every one of her students. Maren's excitement for science, especially polymer chemistry, is contagious. Her enthusiasm for chemistry comes alive when she's in the classroom and no doubt transfers to her students. She truly has influenced the lives of so many Smithies. Maren's mentorship doesn't end after her students graduate. This year, as a first-year graduate student, she has reached out multiple times to me to see how I'm adjusting. And I most definitely did call her after a, let's just say, upsetting first thermodynamics exam, and she provided that exact same patience, empathy, and direction that she did on the day of the flood. Maren has taught me how to approach science and life in general with a mindset that setbacks are not the end, but rather they are just the beginning. And I'm confident to say that any one of Maren's students would agree with me. I would like to conclude by thanking you, Maren. You should be incredibly proud of the students you have impacted through your love for chemistry, your ability to teach with so much compassion, and your astounding mentorship. Congratulations on this much-deserved honor.
Maren Buck, Associate Professor of Chemistry. Polymer chemistry, just one of your areas of scholarly interest, is all about connection. Smaller molecules attach themselves to one another to create a powerful chain of interlocking units, each with its own unique properties and attributes. In many ways, this reflects your own approach to teaching. Whether instructing a class or leading a lab, you encourage a highly collaborative environment in which students work toward a common goal while bringing their own experiences, ideas, and perspectives to their studies and their research. Consequently, your students are deeply invested in the art of scientific discovery. As one student wrote, "Professor Buck's class is like a little community. We are all in it together, working as a team, holding each other up, and never leaving anyone behind." Your labs in particular inspire students to imagine how their experiments could advance science, address real-world problems, or improve someone's health and well-being. Your own research using both chemically reactive and synthetic polymers may one day lead to applications in peripheral nerve repair, tissue regeneration, and more targeted therapies for various forms of cancer. For your scholarly innovation, dedication to your students, and belief in the power of science to transform lives, Smith College is proud to award you the 2021 Sherrerd Prize for Distinguished Teaching. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Got my cheat sheet, because without chemistry up here, I don't know if I'd remember what to say. I can't thank May and Kathy enough for those very kind comments, and thank you to the students and faculty who nominated me for this award. I am deeply honored to be here. I have to tell you, though, that when Kathy called me last spring to tell me about this, I was expecting her to call me about something else. Perhaps related to buildings we've flooded or fires we've lit. But when she told me it was about this award, I found myself without words. The first thought that came to mind was that this can't possibly be right because I'm still learning to teach. And apparently she didn't misdial. We're here 6 months later. But I've mulled over that thought about how I'm learning to teach. And I think that's actually a really important part to what being an effective teacher is. The willingness and enthusiasm to learn as you go and embrace the things that work in the classroom and learn from the things that don't. And I truly love learning. I love learning about chemistry and sharing the aha moments with my students. I love learning about teaching and finding the ways to communicate well the ideas and concepts of our subject. I love learning about learning, learning about how students perceive information. So for me, coming to work every day is like winning the career lottery. And I certainly wouldn't be standing here if it weren't for a lot of people who have supported me along the way. I'm truly grateful and privileged to have two parents whose own enthusiasm for learning and education have led me to this place. I thank my mom for never just agreeing with me, and I hope she's laughing at that, and instead constantly pushing me to think more deeply and critically about the world. I thank my dad for inspiring in me a love for science and the natural world, and I thank my sister for playing teacher with me all those years ago. And I especially thank my husband, whose creativity, thoughtfulness, and innovation in his own classroom constantly pushes me to be a better educator. I'm deeply grateful to my Smith colleagues, and in particular my chemistry colleagues, who have shown me what effective and compassionate teaching looks like while giving me the space to find my own style. And finally, and perhaps most importantly, I'm very grateful for all the Smith students, past, present, and future, whose enthusiasm, curiosity, and willingness to tackle hard problems make it a true pleasure to come to work every day. So thank you again for this award. Deeply appreciate it. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. My name is Mackenzie Swart, and I graduated just this past May as an Ada Comstock Scholar. It is my great honor to be here this evening to introduce Gaby Immerman to you and to celebrate her as an exceptional Smith College educator. Two or three minutes isn't enough time to do her introduction justice, even if I simply listed the many Smith projects and community organizations that she has led or been a part of. I know her best as my mentor, my coach, and the greatest teacher I've ever had. After everything I had read online about them, Gaby's classes were the ones I had been looking forward to the most upon starting my journey at Smith. When we met, it seemed to me like she really saw me, and in fact, she saw right through me. I remember a conversation with her after our long first semester, feeling blindsided by transplant shock, running from one manic idea to another. Due in part to the many frustrating obstacles I had gotten tangled in, I was beginning to very seriously consider leaving Smith. As she and I sat on a bench in Seeley Hall after class one day, she told me, "You're like a wild horse. I can hitch you to a plow if you really want to pull. I think you need to pull something." I was blown away. She was totally right. I needed focus for my energy, and she had plenty of ideas. In that moment, she tucked me under her wing and helped me to stabilize. This seemingly small act of listening and grounding is, to me, the mark of a very special teacher, one who has an uncommon natural ability to change the course of a student's life. When I reflect on the time I spent at Smith, something I hold very dearly is that I found in Gaby a connection to someone who thrives in the world of higher education, a system I had grown to challenge and resent. That plow she had me pull was to work within the rigid maze of academia and find ways to amplify my voice from a place of community within instead of anger and distrust from without. It was very hard, but I was never alone. In fact, I am one of a herd, a pack, a massive gaggle that comes tumbling down after Gaby under grassy hills behind her to gawk at flowers and stomp through the woods. We take scribbly, colorful notes during her lectures on trees and plants, and after class, half of us would crowd around her to ask our desperate questions and set up meetings for coffee and advice. Meeting with her always felt to me like I'm stepping out of a world for a few minutes into a place where I get to peek at the bigger picture that she is so in tune with. I am infinitely grateful to Gaby for all of the emotional, mental, and physical work she does, all 25 hours of the day, it seems, to reach out and care for all of her students, for me, through each of our unique chapters in life. She's a beacon of friendly guidance in a college bubble that emphasizes the value of its own hierarchy and privately ignores or invalidates the efforts of those who do not come up through that system traditionally, like me. I look forward to a future where more teachers reflect Gaby's drive and love for her work and who are valued just as highly for having experience in their field as they are for having a degree in it. I believe Gaby will remain firmly planted in the collective knowledge of the student body for many years to come, for the reasons I have shared here and more. We have been recognizing her for a long time as a distinguished teacher, so thank you finally for very much for finally joining us. Congratulations, Gaby.
Gabrielle Immerman, Senior Laboratory Instructor in Biological Sciences. Your passions for honoring the land, creating beautiful gardens, and promoting food security have inspired you to branch out into several areas in your chosen field. For the past 15 years, you have led the innovative summer internship program at the Smith College Botanic Garden, encouraging students to develop a deep appreciation for everything botanical. Your belief in the power of our natural environment to enhance our lives informs every aspect of your teaching. In one of your most popular assignments, you ask students to take a weekly walk around campus in the spring to observe the progression of various plants as they bloom. As one student said, "The revelations I have had through this project will live with me as I experience the change of seasons for the rest of my life." Your dedication to plant education extends to our local community as well. As Vice President of Grow Food Northampton, you help manage the operation of a 120-acre community garden and a vibrant downtown farmers market in an effort to support food security for low-income families throughout the region. For your ability to instill in students a love and respect for the earth and all it can provide, Smith College is proud to award you the 2021 Sherrerd Prize for Distinguished Teaching. Congratulations, Gaby.
Thank you both. That was the two sides of me right there. This is a lot of attention. It hasn't always been like this. This is my 22nd year at Smith, and for the first 16, I don't think anyone besides students and the Botanic Garden staff knew I was even here. But when the previous Botanic Garden director retired in 2016, a decision was made to separate the teaching of the venerable old Smith horticulture courses from the job description of the Botanic Garden director, where they had resided for over 140 years. I was asked at that time to cover the lectures in addition to the labs that I'd been hired to teach. So that was 7 years ago. Common law marriage, you might say. Seems to be working out pretty well. So I have a confession to make. I'm not an academic. Fun fact, during my own college years, I dropped out of not one but two Ivy League colleges. It all seemed so theoretical. At that time in my life, I was really struggling with what I now understand was a false dichotomy between the life of the mind and the more kinetic, grounded satisfaction and ways of knowing that I had found in work on the farms, nurseries, and parklands that I fled to in between semesters. Unlike many of you, I never in a million years would have thought I'd be entering my third decade of teaching at a prestigious liberal arts college like Smith. And yet, ironically, I think it is that realness that is the soul of my success as a teacher. Students recognize and respond to the authenticity, the enthusiasm, it's joy, really, that I feel in getting to turn them on to the magical mysteries of botany, of soil, awakening their plant literacy here in this gorgeous landscape with its 150-year-old trees, glasshouses, and 10,000 plants from all over the world. Whether we're tromping around campus, hybridizing mums, co-creating design projects in the Mill River Greenway Lab, thinking pragmatically about how to challenge the colonial history of botanic gardens, we are learning by doing, mind and hands and heart all engaged. I take very seriously the privilege, the responsibility really, to be the mentor, the coach, the uncle that I myself could really have used at this tumultuous formative age. To say the things that I wish I'd heard, to affirm them, to challenge them, to engage them, to hear them, to see them, to teach them the way that I wish I'd been taught, hands-on, heart-first. I'm an odd duck here at Smith, half laboratory instructor, half staff who teach. This is the first time someone from that not always visible cohort has received this recognition. In fact, lab instructors were not even eligible for consideration until 2018 when we were voted onto the faculty. There's a lot of discussion at Smith these days about experiential learning, and rightly so. These can be some of the most formative and lasting experiences that students encounter here. So, as lab instructors and staff who teach, we've been out here doing it all along. So, Marnie, Lily, Annie, Valerie, Charlene, Shannon, Emma, Sam, Gina, Chris, John, Tracy, Emily, Judith, Lori, Erin, I'm very proud to accept this award on behalf of all of us. I hope it's the first of many. Thanks.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for being here. My name is CMR Giordano. I'm a 2017 AdaCom Stock graduate. Our chief want in life is someone who will make us do what we can. While those words were attributed to Emerson, I learned that lesson best from Michelle Joffroy. As a faculty member and a mentor, Michelle has an amazing talent for tapping into the you that you didn't even realize you dreamed of. Most importantly, she helps that capable version of you step into the light. Michelle and I met during my first term at Smith in an unconventional way. I was a chilly morning, and she was behind me and my housemate on our way to Chuck It to sit at the Spanish language tables. I was giving my friend an unsolicited commentary on Castilian pronunciation, never knowing that I had a member of the Spanish department walking right behind me. When we each had gathered our plates and headed to sit at the Spanish table, I was mortified to see her sitting there. After about 20 awkward minutes, we began speaking, and she chuckled about my commentary, added some of her own, which immediately made me feel like I was in great company. Thereafter, I was fortunate enough to take many formative and stimulating classes with her that allowed me to bring my voice and my own philosophies into academic spaces. This was something I had not realized I was capable of until that moment. Because of Michelle's influence, guidance, and encouragement, I was able to realize other capabilities. For example, in my senior year, Michelle oversaw my special study on multilingual justice, which allowed me to investigate society's uses of language to disempower others rather than to foster better understanding of each individual's lived experiences and epistemologies. Also during that term, it was my pleasure and honor to work as Michelle's teaching assistant in her domestic ed class, where I connected with fellow students and helped foster their deeper understanding of the precarity of domestic work. Finally, and most wonderfully, I was able to do work as a transcriptionist during my summer praxis for the National Domestic Workers Alliance Oral History Project. During this praxis, Michelle's support was critical in convincing stakeholders that raw transcriptions had to be maintained in the archive to fully reflect the spoken words of each of the participants. In each of these experiences, I was reminded of the value of listening closely to how things were said, who was doing the talking, and how what they said was perceived. After I graduated from Smith and moved into my own career, I was able to see the want that I had had. I wanted to be a teacher, a listener, and a facilitator. I was also able to understand the impact of what I had learned from Michelle in my professional spaces. In my own Spanish classroom, I was able to support students' understanding of their work while allowing them to accomplish what they could. Working in higher education, I could see what Michelle had seen in me and, more importantly, brought out in me. I believe that much of this would not have been possible without her support and mentorship. I can say unequivocally that she is and always has been an amazing educator. But what she does in the classroom for each student differently is unlock their true potential through her humility, fierce Mexicana power, love, and humor. The humor is essential because, in the words of Rosario Castellanos, we have to laugh. Because laughter, we already know, is the first evidence of freedom. Thank you, Michelle, for all you have taught me and all of the other Smithies that have learned from you. Thank you for the Sherrerd Center for Teaching and Learning for bringing us together to witness this moment of recognition of her amazing work.
Michelle Joffroy, Associate Professor of Spanish and Portuguese. For more than two decades, you have taught your students that scholarship is at its most powerful when it is grounded in community-based partnerships and fueled by the voices and experiences of those who lead movements for justice around the world. As co-director with History Professor Jennifer Guglielmo of the Digital Humanities Public History Project with the National Domestic Workers Alliance, you are bringing this approach to bear in incredibly meaningful ways. Specifically, in your classes, students work alongside you to research and develop a comprehensive timeline documenting the experiences of organizers of the domestic workers movement, thus ensuring that these important but often missing stories become part of the historical record. One of your students recently noticed that among students, you are known for creating an intellectual community in which we grapple with the ideas of justice, indigenous resistance, constructions of gender, and women's experience by processing the stories, words, and texts of Latin American and indigenous women in each and every class. Your own scholarship on questions of gender, ethnicity, transnational feminism, and ecological social movements is a source of inspiration to all who take your classes. For your dedication to your students and your belief in the power of education and intellectual curiosity to make change, Smith College is proud to award you the 2021 Sherrerd Prize for Distinguished Teaching. Congratulations.
Thank you, Kathy. I'm really honored to receive this award, so thank you. I'd actually like to say a few more words of thanks before I start saying other things. First, thank you, Xiomara, for your comments and for making the trip back here to Smith to stand alongside me, and for the work that you're doing with your students at Bennington every day. They are really fortunate, as was Smith, that you said yes. Thank you to the dining, residents, custodial, and building staff for the hard work that you do to keep student spaces, classrooms, and offices safe, nourishing, welcoming, and beautiful places. Thank you, Andrea Fernandez and Kayla Cheneba, and the tech staff for organizing and coordinating everything that's gone into making this event possible in such a tenuous moment when gathering together feels really necessary but is also very challenging. And thank you to the members of the Sherrerd Committee for the hours that you've spent thinking about this award and for the respect with which you approach the task you've taken on. I know it must be hard work, but hopefully it is gratifying as well. Congratulations, Maren and Gaby, on an award that is more than well-deserved. Your students are incredibly lucky, but so are we as your colleagues. I'll echo and affirm basically everything that Maren and Gaby expressed. It is a privilege to do our work here, to have access to incredible resources, and to be able to mature and to grow as teachers and scholars in the company of such brilliant students, colleagues, friends, and brujas. But I actually just want to speak to my students, to our students, as they are, of course, the beating heart that makes all of this possible. Compañeras, I'm grateful to be in the company of your fierce intelligence and the burning fire that you're feeding as you study, work, and learn together. You bring that fire to the classroom. Sometimes it roars. Sometimes it's a gentle, even flame. And you invite me to come closer, closer to it, with your questions, with your curiosity, and more importantly, with the knowledge that you've already built that fire with. I want to acknowledge how much I have learned from you in the warmth of those fires. I'd like to say that for many of us, education has sometimes felt like a force that was singularly directed at extinguishing our fire. I grew up in Nogales, Arizona, a small town on the U.S.-Mexico border at a time when speaking Spanish in school was prohibited for Mexicano children. So the first lesson I learned in kindergarten was that really the only language that I could speak with any passion or authority at 5 years old was against the rules. And that lesson was enforced in both subtle and not so subtle, but always painful ways. So I learned to keep that language and its knowledge pretty well protected. But I also cultivated the suspicion that there were bigger things at stake, that something in the speaking of my language, in the authority of my culture and history, was not just against the rules, it was unsettling something. And I appreciate that for many of you, both that suspicion and the strategies for protecting what you know are constant companions. But we're living and learning and teaching in a time where the stakes are really high. The planetary struggles over whose knowledge, whose cultures, whose histories and languages will shape the future are very real. And though the classroom can offer us a space to step away, to transcend some of these struggles, which is precious and beautiful and also necessary, I want to encourage you, my fellow students, to keep feeding your fire, to bring it to the classroom, to invite others in, to bring us closer so that your knowledge and our knowledge can shape a future where we all will have a space. Compañeras, sigan alimentando los fuegos, sigan construyendo un mundo en el que muchos mundos quepan.
So in a minute, I'm going to ask you to join me one more time in congratulating the 2021 winners of the Sherrerd Teaching Awards. But before I get to that, I'm going to go just slightly off script to say this. The plaque displayed currently outside the Carroll Room, honoring all the winners since the program's inception, will soon be relocated to the Nielsen Library, where the plaques were previously displayed. Maren, Gaby, and Michelle's names will be added in the Nielsen browsing room alongside the other winners. And as I look out on the audience today, I see some of those other winners here. And I hope that as I invite you to join me in congratulating this year's winners again, the previous winners will stand so that we can see representatives of the community of scholar teachers that our new recipients are joining. Please welcome our past and present winners as we congratulate them one more time. Thank you all for your attendance here with us in person or virtually. I hope that when you see Maren or Gaby or Michelle on campus, you take that opportunity to congratulate them as well. Thank you all and have a good evening.